Press.
Shalom to everyone. Today we're learning Zera Shimshon, Parashat Nitzavim, letter Hey. The last Zera Shimshon in Parashat Nitzavim. Of course, the zechut of Zera Shimshon to be again Aleinu, he should pray to be Melitz Yosher for Klal Israel, especially for our communities, those who learn his Seforim, that HaShem should perform us open miracles, and HaShem should give everyone refuah shlema, refuah tanefesh, refuah taguf, v'cheni ratzon v'naman, amen. First of all, shlema to Yosef ben Eliyahu. Today's his birthday, he's a nice guy, I know him. And also the refuah shlema to be...
Happy birthday, Rabbi.
Thank you. The refuah shlema also to Berta Bat Yafa. She has procedure. She had one procedure today, one tomorrow. The refuah shlema, she should be happy and healthy. And also, Svetachaya Bat Mazal. And the refuah shlema, Chol Cholei Amo Yisrael, everyone. And I would like to say thank you to our sponsors, Ariel Ben Yosef Leah Ilyabayev, and also Daniel Ben Yaakov.
Aaron Ben Daniel,
and also should be Refuah Shlema, Aaron HaKohen Ben Daniel, Refuah Shlema, Adonai Shavuot Guf, Kenil Zon, Amen.
Amen.
And we would like to say Leilu Nishmat. Kol HaNiftarim Yosef Ben Tuvia, and also our dear friend that used to come sometimes to Shiurim 2 weeks ago, and the big Shiur, he was here, happy and healthy. Unfortunately, HaShem has his own cheshbonot. We cannot ask questions. Le'elui Nishmat, Elazar, Izik, Ben Tamara, Ruach HaShem Tenichenu Bagan Eden, and also Amnon Ben Istam, Vagam David Ben Osnat, וגם אפרי בן מלכה, וגם כל הנפטרים והנפטרות, יהודו בן נעמו, וכן יהי רצון ונאמר, רב מרדכי בן תמר, רב אהרון וולקין בן אסתר, רב נחמיה זלמן גולדברג בן שרה, רוח השם תניחם בגן עדן, וכן יהי רצון ונאמר, אמן. They should pray for us, and we should have a lot of הצלחה, a lot of successful signature and sealment on Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur. Okay, in the Parsha, Nitzavim, chapter 30, Pasuk 15 says, Re'en atati lefanecha, Hashem says, see, look, I put in front of you, Hayom, today, et ha-chayim ve-et ha-tov, life and good, ve-et ha-mavet ve-et ha-ra, death and bad. Why Torah says life and good, death and bad? Of course, then Torah says, what do bacharta v'chayim? Choose life. Then Torah says, "Asher anochi mitzavcha hayom," that I command you today, le'ahavai Adonai Elohecha, to love Hashem, lalechet bidrachav, to follow His path, to go by His ways, velishmor mitzvotav, guard mitzvot, v'chukotav, and commandments, mishpatav, laws, v'chayita v'ravita. So you should live and you should multiply. U'berachecha Adonai Elohecha, and Hashem will bless you ba'aretz in the land asher ata ba'asham alelishta, that you will come there to inherit. Now, what we see from here, you want to be blessed? Simple. Love Hashem. I understand some people want to keep Torah and Mitzvot. Oh, you know, if I don't, then what's going to happen? Genam, in Genganed, and here, there. We are in different level, Baruch Hashem. We need to learn how to love Hashem. Love comes when someone doesn't even tell you something. If you like a girl, you want to marry her, she tells you, okay, bring me one flower. You're not going to give her one, you're going to give her 10, 20, 30. Why? Because you love her. Same thing with Hashem. Hashem says, keep Shabbat. Keep Shabbat, it doesn't mean keep Shabbat like a robot. You know, 7:20 comes in, 7:20 comes in. 8:30 comes out, 8:30 comes in. No. 7:20 comes in, you keep Shabbat 7:10, 10 minutes extra. 8:20 comes out, you come out at 35, you know, 15 minutes extra. Love, love. You come to Shi'ur, Shi'ur starts at 8 o'clock, you come 7:55, 5 minutes extra. That is love. When you do mitzvot with love, you feel Hashem. You don't need to get scared. Oh, it's going to be... Then keep Torah mitzvot. When you do with love, you keep much faster, much stronger, and you have more connection because you love. Same thing. If king has servants, one servant who love him and one servant who has fear from him, when he says, go buy me, make a shopping for me, the one who loves comes faster and comes with a better fruits. The one that fears and says, oh, I gotta be careful. You know, he puts every step thinking twice. You have to have fear of Hashem, but you should know the main thing is love. Love. And second thing, we're entering Rosh Hashanah. Someone recently, 2 days ago, told me from the name of Rav Shneir Zalman of Liadi, who passed away 12 days before Rosh Hashanah. He passed away 2 days ago, was his yahrzeit. Chai Elul. Same thing, Baal Shem Tov. And after Baal Shem Tov passed away, he was earlier than Rav Shneir Zalman. And after Baal Shem Tov passed away, they said he passed away 12 days before Rosh Hashanah to explain people that 12 days, each day stands for 1 month. If that day you fix for the whole month. So if let's say today is the third day began, from Aravit, third day began, so first month Tishrei, Cheshvan, Kislev. So whoever did not come to Shul the month of Kislev, he could fix it tonight by coming to the Shul. Simple. Every day for a month. But do whatever you want. Teshuvah is important. Learn some Musar Sefer. Learn some Gemara. Learn Alachot. Learn. Add time to you. I'm not saying some with us. No. At home, yourself. With us, you learn whatever we learn. In school, guys, you learn whatever you learn. At home, make your own time. Add time. 5, 10 minutes, 15, 20 minutes. When you add, you feel connection. And you must enter Rosh Hashanah happy. Smile, happy. Hashem sees your happiness and He increases your year. And Hashem says, I want to give you another year. So everyone should have this year successful in tefillot. I'm not going to say, oh, you know, we didn't pray last year good. This pandemic came. 66 rabbis just in New York passed away. I'm not going to say that. Why? Because maybe it should have been worse. And our prayers saved it. How do I know? Because our Pesach was so hard. Everyone cried on Seder night. We cannot go to shul. We cannot be with family. Some parents cannot be with their children. Some children cannot be with parents. Terrible, terrible.
Every 5 seconds you heard the ambulance.
Every 5 seconds ambulance. I'm telling you, I never experienced in my life thinking on Pesach night, I won't be able to sleep. Every 30 minutes, 45 minutes, people would come, knock on the door. Where is your brother's house? Where is your brother's address? We have relative who passed away. We need to take care of that person. We need to come Chevra Kadisha and take care of it. I'm telling you, we had very not easy Pesach. And I was every time getting up and I was praying to Hashem, please, take the pandemic away from us. We deserve to have good life. And Baruch Hashem, Hashem listened to tefillot. Many, many communities, they don't even know what pandemic is all about. It's already much better. People get sick, but they don't go to the hospital. It doesn't need to be in a hospital. This is how it's more minor. But of course, Hashem should take it away fully from the world. Everyone Amen. Should have Rafua Shlema, Father Nefesh, Father Guf. V'cheni Ratzon V'nomar Amen. Rosh Hashanah, we have to be happy, but we have to be humble. Anytime, kol hashana shelash bitchilata mitasheret basofa, says in the Gemara Rosh Hashanah, page 17, I believe, 16b, 17. It says, any year that begins with a humbleness or with a poorness end up with richness. Mm-hmm. So what does that mean? Come humble. Doesn't mean you're not happy, but you're humble. Hashem, my future is in your hands. I'm humble. I'm like poor, like I have nothing. I'm happy. I'm connected to you. You should know, the connection to Hashem, no money in the world can replace it. A person could be the most poor, when he eats on Pesach, Seder, Matzah, he have to recline on the left side. We say, excuse me, why are you reclining? You don't have $100 in the back of your pocket, so why are you reclining? He says, no, I have connection with Hashem. I'm not by Paro as a servant that I could be rich, but I cannot keep my mitzvot. That's poor. When I'm connected with Hashem, that is rich. That is rich. That is wealthy. Why? You connected with Almighty, with Hashem. He could control anything. Now, knowing this, we could start Zera Shimshon. Hashem says, Re'en atati lefanecha. Look, I put before you. Hayom, when? Today.
Now.
Today, there's two answers. Answer number one, anytime it says today, you have to know it's today, dafka today. Like, don't think, oh, I have to love Hashem, I'll start my love tomorrow. No, today. Number two, anytime Zohar says, anytime it says today, it means Rosh Hashanah. Rosh Hashanah. Hayom harat olam. Today is the day of creation. Okay. Re'en atati lefanech hayom et hachayim v'et hatov. Hashem says, I put in front of you life and the good. To have life and to be good is two different things. Next it says, v'et hamavet v'et hara. And Hashem says, I put in front of you death and bad. Life and good, death and bad. So now, Zera Shimshon is really bothered. A, why you always start from good and then bad? Good and life, bad, death and bad. Kashe, this is difficult. Shayalo lomar mitchila et hamavet v'et hara. Torah should have said in the beginning, I put in front of you death and
bad.
Then Torah should say, I put in front of you life and good. This is how it says in Midrash. Sheitzchag amar, because Yitzchak Avinu said to Yaakov Avinu, Orerecha arur umevarechecha baruch. Sheitzchak, honestly, Midrash says over there, when Yaakov Avinu comes to his father, and Yaakov Avinu says, I am Esav, Yitzchak Avinu gives bracha, right? Esav gets bracha and runs away. Yaakov Avinu gets bracha and goes out. Really, he bought the bracha. It belongs to him. Yitzchak Avinu was blind. He did not know that was Yaakov. And he wanted to curse him. Came angel Achteriel and said, excuse me? You want to curse him? Don't you remember how Hashem said to your father Avram Avinu, Orerecha arur umuvarechecha baruch. The one who curses you will be cursed, and the one who blesses you will be blessed. Therefore, Yitzchak Avinu said, Gam baruch yeh. Okay, if so, let him be blessed. This is how angels saved Yaakov Avinu from the curse of his father. Therefore, by Yitzchak Avinu says what? Orecha arur umuvarechecha baruch. Whoever will curse you will be cursed. Whoever is blessing you will be blessed. So what begin first? Curse. So why Torah when says, I put in front of you, it says, I put in front of you life and good. Life and good, death and bad. Why it starts from life? It should be opposite. But Bil'am said opposite. Ul Bil'am amar lehefech. Because it says, "Lefisha tzadikim tchilatan yisurin v'sofan shalva." Because by tzadik, in the beginning he suffers, in the end he enjoys. Rasha is opposite. V'arshaim tchilatan shalva v'sofan yisurin. V'arshaim, in the beginning they enjoy, in the end they suffer. So the answer for all these questions that we asked. Why it says life first and not death? The answer is Veshlomar. The answer is Dahacha lo haya efshar lomar techila et hamavet v'et hara. Here Torah couldn't have say and the death and bad. Why Torah couldn't start? Ve'im ken, if it would be like that, have a mashma shelachar sheba hara yesh takana lizchot betov. If person would get bad, I would think, don't worry, after bad you'll get good. Excuse me? After person dies, kakoy good. What kind of good is going to have in this world? He's done. I mean, we're not talking Olam Haba. Olam Haba, yes, there is Gan Eden, there is enjoyment, yes. We're talking about this world for now. Veze eino. And that's not true. Shele olam tzarich she'adam yakdim tefila letzara. Person should always pray before the problem comes in. Why? Once the problem is there, maybe you won't be able to make it through. So therefore, you have to pray before the problem comes in. And also we said, Gemara Baba Kama, page 80b, Delet hanin eled lo bimhera tipatach. The door that is closed, locked, it's not so simple to unlock it. Rabbi Baruch Aram, do you agree? Okay, thank you. Tani Dibur, I wish I also have Tani Dibur. Guys, do you understand what he's saying here? Once the door is locked, it's not easily opened. We still have 10 days, 11 days. We have 10 days for Rosh Hashanah. The doors are open now for Teshuvah. If I don't make Teshuvah until Rosh Hashanah and the door gets closed, it's much harder from Rosh Hashanah to Yom Kippur to open the doors. Or could be, since that week is called Aseret Yimei Teshuvah, I still have chance to open their doors. But after Yom Kippur, done. The gates are closed. This is why it's called Ne'ilah. What's Ne'ilah? To lock it. Ne'ilah is to lock. Once it's locked from Shamayim, it's very hard to open it. Teshuvah is hard to do. The Gong Desh. Rav Ilan, thank you. Delet anin eled lo bimera tipatach. Yes, there is ways to make teshuva further after. Don't depend on that. Smart person wakes up on time, makes teshuva right away. Umishum achi ikdim achayim v'atov. Therefore, it says what? Hashem says, I put in front of you today life and good, death and bad. You choose. Why it starts life and good? Sheitbag be'elu kodem she'yavo ha'ara chas v'shalom. Attach yourself with the life and good. So it should be before it comes to bad. Once you do life and good, you attach yourself with life. Bad is not going to come to you. Why? Because you attach yourself with life, with good. The whole thing is one word. What's the word? Teshuvah. If you make teshuvah now, you attach yourself with life. You attach yourself with good. What is life and what is good, we'll see right now. You know the worst mistake people do is tomorrow. Mm-hmm. Why is it problem to say tomorrow?
Tomorrow belongs to you.
Let me explain to
tomorrow
you one thing.
Tomorrow never may become.
Rabbi Aaron, thank you. Tomorrow maybe not come. How do you write Amalek? Can you please tell me the spelling? Ayin.
Ayin Mem Lamed.
Guys, you're going too fast. We gotta go slowly. I'm not that experienced. Ayin Mem Lamed Kuf. Ayin stands for the word Ayev. What means Ayev? I'm tired. Come to Shiur. I'm tired. You say I'm tired and you don't go to Shiur, you feed your Amalek. And now he has power against you. But if you do come Shiur, whatever throughout the year you couldn't come to the shul, you take it back from Amalek. Now you go. You know, Rabbi Ilan today was exhausted. He put his head on the pillow and said, today is Monday, right? Because yesterday was Labor Day. He said, oh no, today is Zera Shimshon Day. I'm getting up and I'm going. Today is Zechut for 52 Zera Shimshons of the year.
Zechut your birthday, I came up, I don't.
Thank you. Then there's a second letter, Mem. What's Mem? This is the reason why we're saying it now. Machar! Make teshuvah. It says tomorrow. Keep Shabbat tomorrow. Wear tefillin tomorrow, sir. Sometimes, unfortunately, that tomorrow doesn't come.
Die is that tomorrow.
Achshav. Why are you feeding your Amalek. The next one is Lamed. What Lamed? Lo chashuv. What's lo chashuv? It's not important. He says, it's not a big deal. Later, when I be 60, then. Too late, sir. It's important now. And kuf is what? Do you know it's really hard for me? Kasher. Kasher, hard. He says, it's really hard. I have to go to shiur, sit over there? Ze kasher, it's hard for me. If Rabbi Ilan likes it, that's all, guys.
Worth it to come for this chiddush.
I can't, what?
He goes to shiur.
Can I tell you something?
Effort.
He goes to shiur, he sleeps. When he gets mitzvah for going to shiur, when he sits by the shiur or when he walks to shiur? That's right. So at least he got schar pesiot. At least he got that. Can I tell you something? One guy, he used to go to dafyomi shiurim. One guy used to come dafyomi shiurim. He would work 18 hours a day, one person talking. 18 hours a day he would go work. 18 hours. He would come home only for sleeping. He was exhausted. He would come to shiur, boom. As soon as rabbi's mouth opens, his eyes closes down. Okay?
Lullaby.
So what happened is,
lullaby,
that's right. And the whole shiur goes like this. A rabbi came up to him one day, said, listen, Avram, can I ask you a question? He says, yes, sure, rabbi, why not? He says, you come to shiur, I barely think you don't understand nothing. He says, I do grasp one thing every shiur. He says, but why do you come? You're so exhausted, you sleep all night. He says, you don't understand. When you ask my wife, where is your father? He says, my father went to shiur. Just to teach my son a lesson that even though I'm exhausted, I was 18 hours a day, but I go the end of the day shiur, that is good chinuch. And that child became big talmid chacham. Can I tell you something? Not always Hashem cares about how much you know. This is our mistake in this generation. People care about information. They get information, they say, oh, I know information. Wrong. It's not the information the main thing. It's your action, your love, your derech eretz to it. If you come to shiur because you respect Torah, you love Torah, even though you didn't learn much, Hashem says you will get full power of this shiur and full power in the how you say nagrada?
Reward.
Your children will be talmidei chachamim, Hashem says. Why? Because you give the most kavod. I don't care how much you understood, but you give the most kavod, your children will be talmidei chachamim. It's not easy to have children talmidei chachamim. Sometimes you have tefillot, sometimes you have tears, sometimes you have to give time, you give no sleeping day and night. It's a process. It's a big process.
Big dedication, big.
Nobody can say, I didn't do nothing for my son, he became talmidei chacham by himself. Not true. Not true. If you would see Rachmat Kuna Elazar, Izik Tzadik, of how proud he was, says, even this time I sent Moshe to learn. Unfortunately, Moshe didn't even come out from quarantine, he had to come back because his father passed away. But the happiness, he would say to Rav Ovadia, you know, I sent my son to Israel. You know, from one side he was very happy, from one side he was upset that, you know, his son is learning not near him. But I'll tell you one thing. You have no idea how Torah learning is important. Guys, if you teach your children learning every moment when you have free time, do you know what is this? Why should we waste our time? Why should we give our life to these cell phones? Cell phone used for phone, for calling, find out how's your family, making maybe business, learning Torah. But phone is not for games. Why should you give your life for this shtuyot? I was very upset when I saw on Tisha B'Av 2-3 people were sitting on the floor and playing 8-ball bull, this bull, then some of them playing solitary game. I said, excuse me? Do you think it's better for you to go home and lie down and play here in front of Hashem when Hashem is crying for you and you're playing a game? This is what's important, guys. We have to value our time. Time is very important. It's more than any money in life. Time is lost, you cannot replace. Money lost, you could replace. Time you cannot replace. Appreciate value. Let's go now a little bit faster. I have what, 7 minutes? I'll finish 10 minutes. Thank you. Ve'od. Yesh lakshot. Also we could ask. Ala pasuk. Delefi Maida Amrinan Bepere Kamedetanit. By the way, the Luya family, Gansberg family, Minu family, all those people who support us throughout different shiurim, Hashem should give them brachas lacha. Everyone come here who learn, or those who are not here today, Hashem should give them bracha ravacha v'atzlacha. K'tivu v'tichtemu b'sefer chayim tovim, amen. Ve'od, and also, yesh la'akshot, you could ask, ala pasuk delfi ma'ita amnian b'perek kama de tanit, why in the first chapter tanit says, deki yahiv rachamono sov olecha yehudiyah, when Hashem gives, Hashem not only gives bracha, Hashem fulfills everything, fills up. Hashem gives plenty for life, to enjoy, to remain life, to be full. Lo have tzarech kol memor ela re'natati lefanecha atov. Why Torah says, hine natati lefanecha et ha'chayim et ha'tov, life and good. Just say, I put in front of you good. Why to say life? When you say good, Hashem does life fully good. Anyway, that's good. So why to say the word life? D'ksheish ha'tov bavada yesh ha'chayim. When you have good, of course you have life. Why Torah says also life? The answer is, since Rasha'im are called dead, utfilatan ena nishmat, person who's Rasha, his prayer is not accepted. Kedichtiv, as it says, ubeperashchem kapechem, mibikesh lot miyetchem. When you raise your hands to pray to Hashem, he said, who asked you this? Who asked you on this? I don't want your tefillah. Rasha prays, Hashem doesn't listen to his tefillot. Today, even though some person doesn't keep kashrut, doesn't keep Pesach, doesn't keep Shabbat, comes to shul to pray, give him sefer. He reads in Russian, give him in Russian. He reads in English, give him in English. He reads in any other language, give him. He's okay. Not Rasha. He's tinok shenishba. It's a child lost between goyim. They didn't have opportunity to learn properly in yeshivot. Even here 20 years ago, Bukharians didn't have opportunity to learn in good yeshivot. Today we have good yeshivot. Next generation Bukharians, look at them, it's going to be amazing. But now, some older people come to shul, don't say, you know, you read from Russian, you better close the book. No, chas v'shalom, what are you talking about? You read from Russian, you're also doing a mitzvah.
Would it be better to
Would be better to learn in Hebrew? If you know how to read in Hebrew a little bit slow than usual, read in Hebrew. Read in Hebrew. Here, Rav Ovadia learned, other people learned. Why you shouldn't try? Try reading Hebrew all the time. One, two times you're gonna be slow, but eventually you'll get there. Wow, wow, wow. Mr. Sasonov, thank you. Jonathan, thank you very much. Tell your parents thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you. Aslacha rava. Say thank you to your parents. Wow. I hope I deserve all these gifts.
You deserve much more.
Vim Ken!
So bottom line, you get connected to Hashem.
Vim Ken! Tzarich Mitzvah, exactly. Bottom line is connected to Hashem.
Rabbi?
Shh, no, no.
Ask a question, no problem.
You just said about reading from Russian, Hebrew, English. I heard from Yitro yesterday, that Yitro, one of the rabbis, got up and said, If you live in America for 20 years and you're still reading from a Russian book, better you close the book. What do you answer to that?
Before your question, I already answered the answer.
Yeah, rewind.
If a person has hard time learning,
29th minute, rewind
and
read.
And he could pray only in Russian or in English, and it's hard time for him to learn in Hebrew, he should still continue praying. Hashem understands all languages. According to Zohar, you create worlds from Hebrew letters. Of course, eventually a person should try hard. Why? Because you have no idea. When you know Hebrew, you understand so many secrets. Torah has so many secrets. Like you see Amalek, Ayin, Mem, Lamed, Kuf. There's so many secrets. You see the word Atem Nitzavim Hayom. Today you're standing all. What's Atem? Aleph Tav Mem. Emet. Atem Emet. You have Emet. You stand in front of Hashem. You know, it's everything. Everything is very deeply, deeply, deeply connected. But if person doesn't know Hebrew yet, he should try to learn. But he should never stop praying. Chas v'shalom. Hashem is waiting for prayer more than we ourselves. Every prayer is important from Hashem. Read from Russian book. Read from me. Of course. Of course. Gemara Megillah. You could say Shema in any language. What are you saying? Any tefillah you could say in any language. V'im ken, if so. Tzarich mitchila she'adam yivakesh lo. Gemara Brachot as well. V'im ken, tzarich mitchila she'adam yivakesh lo chayim im atshuva. If so. What means life and good? A person from beginning should ask himself a life with teshuvah. Hashem give me life that I should make teshuvah. When you repent and you ask for life, or you ask for life with repentance, that is et ha-chaim v'et ha-tov, life and good. Why? Once you make teshuvah, look at this, look. Guys, you have to see how Hashem is talking to us here. Once you want to repent, Hashem says, you're not Rasha anymore. Stop, 10 minutes ago I sinned. You're not Rasha anymore. Once you want to repent, you regret for what you did. You automatically become tzaddik. Why? Because Rasha's tefillah Hashem does not accept. And you became tzaddik. Hashem accepts your tefillah. That's important to know. You know, I'll tell you, yesterday from Rabbi Shalom Gadaev, I learned something. I know him more than 20 years. He used to be a baby when I used to know him. But he said something that I said close to 18 years ago. And it's true. A lot of rabbis talk about it, including Rav Ovadia Yosef, I saw a few times, including Tzidkada Tzadik. I think it's Rabbi Tzadok HaKohen Melublin. He says, the sin is not a big deal. Teshuvah is important. Don't get me wrong. It doesn't mean I go walk around sinning to be in Chas V'Shalom. Once you get into attachment with sinning, you become impure. Even sitting in shul, you're not going to be connected. But when you hold yourself to protect yourself not to sin, and eventually you fall, you can't let the day go without teshuvah. Hour go, minute go, make teshuvah anyway. Why? The connection between you and Hashem should not stop, never.
Rabbi, there's an expression, it's not how you fall, it's how you get up. Get up is the teshuvah.
Get up is the teshuvah? Can I tell you one more?
It's how you get up.
Should I tell you one more?
Please.
The failure is not the one who falls, is the one who remains falling. Who remains, he doesn't get up. He remains sleeping. That's the failure. What's tzaddik? Tzaddik is Sheva Yipol Vekam. Tzaddik who falls 7 times still gets up. Tshuva. Get back together. Somebody says, how can I make tshuva? What do you think Hashem forgive me? Stop. You're not secretary of Hashem. Hashem doesn't need secretaries. Your job is to do what? You fail, make tshuva, make yourself happy, and move on. Don't look back. Move front. Modeh ani lefanecha Hashem. Thank you. You gave me my neshama today. You trust in me. I have to trust in myself and move on in life. Huh? You don't need?
Antidepressants.
Antibodies? What? When you connected with Hashem, there's no word depression here. There's no word stress. There's a love, connection, life. The Shavir Rafelo Ketiv. Zera Shimshon says, Nadia Savakilov. When you make teshuvah, Hashem cures you. Cures. You cure it. Some people want to act like as if they're Malachim of Hashem. You know, I have to sit 3 days thinking, how did I do the sin? For 3 days, it doesn't say Shema anymore. It doesn't say Shema when I say it. Doesn't make feeling. That's it, it's mitzvah. Are you kidding me? Since when you became Hashem's secretary? Hashem does need secretaries. Be who you are. Follow the Torah. Well, Hashem did not know you're going to make a sin. He knew. Why he gives you a chance to leave? He wants your teshuva. He needs your connection. Your love. Hashem is waiting for every one of us more than our own parents waiting. Hashem says, I'm waiting for you every second. Where are you? Come back. So I have to come Rosh Hashanah. Ah, I'm going to blow shofar. I'm going to hear shofar. You know why? Hashem is becoming king. I'm so happy. Inauguration. Some people, lahavdil, billion of the lot. I want Trump to win. You know, can you imagine if he wins? You know, it's like Mechaim. You know, Hebeim. Hello, foolish. 4 years. After 100 years, where are you going to be? Where he's going to be? He making Hashem Melech. HaMelech HaKadosh. Are you happy? You know, Rav Shlomo Zalman Orbach, Gadol Ador, he says, Oy va'avoy to you. Rav Wadzi Yosef says, Oy va'avoy to you. If on Rosh Hashanah you're sitting, remembering your sin, Hashem says, what? I became a king and you're crying? You know, somebody texted me once. I'm sorry, no rachamim on Rosh Hashanah. It's Yom Tov as well. Somebody texted me, was listening to the shiur, in the YouTube, and in Russian they text me, Baruch Hashem, I know to read Russian, I was in Russian school, 150 years ago. So what happened is, he says, why Shlomo HaMelech writes in his Sefer, I don't know, Mishlei Kohelet, I trust him. And he says, when you talk pleasant, people listen, people love to listen. When you scream, people don't like to listen. So he says, why are you screaming? I want to answer to that person, whoever asked this question. It's a $1 million question, by the way. I asked this question 21 years ago when I was learning Gemara from Rav Wolkin. I said, Rebbe, I'm sitting right near you. Why are you screaming? He says, you don't understand. When someone comes to rob your house, you don't tell him, please don't touch furniture. Please don't touch the... I said, Tilawari. Jewelry. Please don't touch jewelry. Please leave it. You can say, stop! Run away! So Rav Wolkin told me, I see you, young guy. 18-year-old, 19-year-old, if I'm not going to scream into your ears, Satan will steal you and you're going to be like a bomb in the middle of the street like other bombs. Mm-hmm. So I got to scream because I don't want Satan to steal you.
Even if he's 60 years old.
So can I tell you something? When someone screams to teach you Torah, he does right. And you have to learn, because if he doesn't scream, you might be stolen by your Yetzer Hara. Sometimes rabbis need to scream, I'm sorry. And I would tell you one good advice to whoever is this. Any rabbi teaches you, don't teach him how to teach you. Believe me. They know what they're doing and they are good. If you go to your doctor, he's giving you prescription, you're going to teach your doctor what prescription to give you? Register your name by my brother. Let's go further. Ma'am Evin, Yavin. ואחר כך יתפלל שיבוא לו הטוב. And person after teshuva, person should what? יתפלל שיבוא לו הטוב. It doesn't have to be on Rosh Hashanah. Today, Arvit time. Tomorrow morning, Shacharit time. You make teshuva. How can you pray Arvit teshuva? How? Yeah, Hashiveinu Avinu. We say 40 days. From Elul, you have to pray for people who are lost, no? Somebody lost, doesn't come home, or goes out with Goya, or he's a little bit getting off the derech. You have to pray for him. You have to stop in the middle of Hashiveinu and say his name. I'm praying for so-and-so by the name. I have a few names also. And I'll tell you, it works. It works very strong.
I only did 8 days so far.
Okay, step by step. We'll go step by step.
Do you make Kavanah?
So now, after Harotze B'Tshuva, after today's fifth bracha, Harotze B'Tshuva, stop. Happy Hashem, I made teshuva, thank you. Now I'm connected to you. He should pray that so good things to come to him. And only then his prayer will be heard. Why? Because he made teshuva, he's tzaddik. And still we could analyze. The Bishlam HaReshet Dekra, Nicha shemitchilato shemitchila yiten lo achayim v'achagach yosiv latet lo atov. We still have to analyze why it says in the beginning give me life and then it says give me good. U'mishumach yamakro et achayim v'et atov. Ah, the Kro Nicha shemitchila yiten lo achayim. First Hashem gives him life. Why? Why? Why Hashem gives him life? Because he did teshuvah. He made teshuvah, so he got life. So now he's after us for good. Now he's asking for good. Now it makes sense the pasuk. Life and then good. He tell him, "Achar kach yosif latet lo atov." Or mishumach yamakro et achayim et atov. Now I understand the pasuk says life and then good. Why? Life you only get only by teshuvah. Therefore, what's the language of life? In the tefillah of Rosh Hashanah Yom Kippur, Zochreinu lechayim, melech hafetz v'chayim, kotvenu b'sefer, chayim lamanach Elohim, chayim, 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 chayim. Why? Because that's the teshuvah. Hashem says, as soon as teshuvah comes out, life. Exactly. Aval sefer dekro lo nicha, the etamavet v'etara. But the end of the pasuk doesn't make sense. What does that mean? And Hashem will give you the death and then bad. Not give you, put in front of you, the death and bad. It says, mashma she'achar mavet etten lo ra. Comes out, the person will have bad after death. Person dead, he doesn't feel nothing. After person is dead, he doesn't know what's good, bad. Go pinch somebody who left the world. You're not going to feel anything. You cannot say it talks about Geinam or Udein Olam Haba. The Ha, Pshat Dekro, Mayri Ba'olam Hazeh Davka. Because the simple Pshat in the Pasuk talks about Olam Hazeh. It doesn't talk about Olam Haba. So the answer is, V'yesh Lomar, V'yesh Lomar. The answer is, the Kavanah Takatuv Ikach. The Kavanah of the Pasuk is like this. Shelifamim Miten Lo Amavet Miyad, Velifamim Miten Lo Amavet Achar Yisurin Kashim V'Raim. Some people have two types of death. One is after terrible suffering, and one is right away. Shehem mar mimavet. Sometimes a person suffers terribly, it's worse, more bitter than death itself. V'hainu detnan, as it says in Pirkei Avot, al korchach atachai, v'al korchach atamet. You come to this world, not your free choice, by force, against your will. You come to this world, and against the will, after 120 days of Hashem, you leave this world. V'chein b'perek gimel dektubot. And chapter 3, Ketubot says, Ketubot, ilule nagdu l'chanane Mishael v'azariah. You remember Chanane Mishael v'azariah, they threw them to the fire? If they would beat them up with a whip. Pal chel atzalmo, they would bow down to the idols. Why? Because when person gets beaten up, he'll do anything. The torture person cannot withhold. I'm sure Gemara doesn't talk about them. They went to the fire. They went to the fire. Talk about even like these people wouldn't be able to withstand the punishment. Also says in Mitzia, if you would kill this guy, he wouldn't give you the secret. But if they would beat him up with a whip, he would give out the maglina, he would open the secret. And also it says by the complainers. What happened to the complainers, those who complained? Yeah, what happened to them? When did they speak Lashon Hara? Huh? Mitonanim is the complainers. They Tishabau. And those ones that complain about the land. Actually, okay, Tishabau. Tishabau, they were talking what happened Hashem did to their tongue, took the tongue and stuck into their belly button. And the worms were going up and down. Worms! Amazing. Nobody can take it away. Worms goes. So what happened? When did they die? 40 days later. Wow. When was that? When was that? No. Guys.
No. Elul.
9th of Av. 40 days later, 18th of Elul. That's the yahrzeit of Baal Shem Tov. That's the yahrzeit of Rav Shneur Zalman of Liadi. And that's the yahrzeit of Melo Daniel Pinchaso. Wow. I see. He left the world.
with big tzaddik. By the way, did you realize one thing scary? On Simchat Torah party, tzaddik of son's friend bought him the picture of
Ben Ishchai,
and he passed away on the yard side of Ben Ishchai. His friend was a young guy. He was on Simchat Torah party.
Also Ben Ishchai. He bought the first one, I bought the second one.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I beat him the first one, and then I beat him the second one, I got it. Almost the same picture, but...
You'll have happy days, don't worry. Hashem should give you Arichud Yavim Veshanim Echen Yitzon. Next. Reshaim Ayu Mitztarim Vaholchim Ad Chodesh Yamim Vahakshelim Metu Miyad. Even the complainers, there were two groups. The Tzadikim died right away. Hashem said, I'm not going to torture you. But the Reshaim, they were tortured for a month and 10 days, or 40 days, and then they died after the torture. And the beginning of the pasuk also it means. What does that mean? Hashem put in front of you et ha'chayim et ha'tov, life and good. What means life and good? Teshuvah and then abundance of life, enjoyment of life. Ve'et ha'mavet ve'et ha'ra. If a person doesn't make teshuvah, then he gets chas v'shalom, death. But before he dies, he gets terrible punishment. So therefore, we're not talking about from negative side, we're talking about positive side. Hashem should help us to do tshuva and seal us in the book of life. Amen.